National Park Service officials say they still don't know what caused part of an Indiana sand dune to collapse and bury a six-year-old boy last year. The boy survived after being trapped under the sand at Mount Baldy in Michigan City for hours. As Barbara Harrington reports, geologists plan to spend the next few weeks on the dune trying to figure out how it happened.
A popular sand dune along the Indiana National Lakeshore is eerily quiet.
We've had people calling all throughout the summer saying, is Mount Baldy open yet? Is Mount Baldy open?
More than 200,000 people make the trip to Mount Baldy in Michigan City every summer. But that changed last year, and this orange cone is a reminder of why.
It would be described as a miracle. I mean, even just the fall is one thing, but then you worry when sand collapses, there usually is not a lot of void space. So it really is a miracle that he was able to survive and is doing so well.
Six-year-old Nathan Wasner became buried under 11 feet of sand when the dune collapsed. Since then, Mount Baldy's remained closed to everyone except geologists who started work on the dune this week.
Geologists do their work by opening up the earth, and when they were rescuing Nathan, emergency responders were on site. It wasn't time for researchers to be there, and the hole needed to be closed up for safety reasons immediately after.
So they're using ground-penetrating radars to create a 3D map of the dune. One of the theories geologists are exploring is whether trees or debris buried by the natural movement of the dune could be decaying and causing openings in the sand. They've discovered six holes, one of them just this week.
I'm not that worried about it. Most of the holes that are occurring out here are in the 10 to maybe 20 centimeters in range, and well, that's the size of my foot.
Larger holes have been documented in other places like Oregon, but they were still significantly smaller than the one Nathan fell into. The research team will turn in a formal report next year. Then the National Park Service will decide whether to reopen Mount Baldy. Both say it's too early to determine whether anything can be done to prevent holes from forming in the dune.